What's up, everybody? I am BK, BKBangers.com. Welcome to another video. Today's video, I want to share with you guys something real quick. It's been a minute since I had to set this up, so I kind of forgot, and I had to backtrack on how to do it. There might be a quicker way how to do it. I'm not sure, but the way that I'm about to show you is very simple. It's just tedious, but simple. So there's the new, everyone knows Studio One 4 is out right now. It just dropped, I think yesterday or the day before, I'm not sure. But you know, I'm a Studio One head, so I had to grab it. And I'm also an MPC head, so I gotta make the best of both worlds, you know, intertwine to work for me. And hopefully this procedure I'm about to share with you guys, it'll help some of you out there who like to use the drum pads as, you know, on the MPC. That's what we about, you know what I mean? So, with that said, the first thing you wanna do is, you wanna load up the MPC as an instance inside of Studio One. You want to go to, you could do it from the hardware. You could go to browser, and then down here it's MIDI control. Hopefully the camera is picking this up, but you go to MIDI control and then you set it up, right? You start to set it up. Now you could do this separately, like you could have the MPC software opened up by itself as an application, Studio One 4 by itself as an application, open up this screen inside the MPC software and do the same steps, all right? So now the tricky part is that in Impact starts on C1. And the MPC originally starts on C, if I go to Bank H, what is it? No, it's Bank D, Bank G. All right, I'm all confused myself. This thing is a little bit confusing if you don't, because, you know, human beings don't speak CC. Right? We don't speak MIDI code, right? So anyway, I think when you open up this originally, it's on pad C-2. That's the lowest octave on the C, right? And it goes up 127 keys upwards. All right, so what you do is, see, right now it's on C1, which is the number 36, right? So the CC number is 36. So you start at 36 and you go up, you just count up as you go along, right? And you go up the banks. Up until you get to, I think it's bank. What it was. That's 100 and that's 99. So up to bank F. When you get to bank F, pad 12 in bank F becomes, that's 127. So here it go, is C2. So C2 is actually zero. That would have been pad 1 originally in the MPC. So what you have to do is, because pad 13 in Impact is actually C negative two, right? So this would be 0, 1, 2, 3, and then you go to G. Then you go to G and the MPC, and that you know, so on and so forth. So the simple thing is just to start at pad on bank A, and in the MPC, you be on bank A, pad one is 36. Just remember 36 and count your way up. And when you get to bank G, when you get to bank F, pad 13 becomes zero. It's a little confusing. I know it was confusing for me. I didn't do it for a minute. The other thing is that now you want to save it, and you have to save it to, you have to save it in a project. So I would suggest that you do this having the MPC software open by itself. If you can just remember the CC notes and just go up, or if you need Studio One to be open so you can map it, is cool to do it that way too. Because it's a little confusing when you have to save here with this as a plugin. So if you have it as a plugin, you go to this little box right here, you go to File, you go to Save Project As, right? Not Save Project, but Save Project As. When it opens up, you name it whatever you're gonna name it, the MIDI scene should automatically save in that project, right? But to double up on that, saving the MIDI scene, you go back to it, you go to File, and right here where it says Save MIDI Control Scene, you select that, you title it whatever you're going to title it. As you can see here, I have Impact Kong MIDI Scene, MIDI Controller Scene, MIDI Scene, because I want to make sure that I have it, right? So that's how you do it. And then once you do that, in Studio One, I don't know about any other software, but in Studio One, you can save this setup as a preset. And how you do that is you go right here to this little paper leaf kind of thing. You open that, and where it says store preset, you would press that, title it. You know, you could replace the preset. You could store it as default preset, which I should have did. Now that I'm going to be controlling Impact with the MPC, with the live. And if you have a MPC X, it's the same thing. If you have an MPC Renaissance and MPC Studio, it's the same things. MPC Touch, same process. All right, it's just the screen is just not as fancy with the MPC Renaissance and the MPC Studio. But that's pretty much it, man. If you have any questions or concerns, post it up in the comment section, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can at my most earliest convenience. I know this was short, simple, and sweet. I ain't doing nothing fancy, but stay tuned. I will get back. I'm about to get busy. So be on the lookout for some more videos coming to you real soon. Do remember that music is life. It is our DNA, y'all. Keep banging. Peace, love, light. Till next time. Peace.